Okay, so live recording has started, and today we got a topic which is exciting and hot topic. And I chose a subject called suppressed sexuality and emotional integration. Why? Because many people in spiritual community, and when they go into spirituality, there is a very often aspect of suppressing physicality. And suppressing physicality, one of the most obvious things that people do is kind of like a desexualizing themselves, suppressing their sexuality, or going in a completely opposite direction and starting to have an open relationship, polyamory and things like that. But I wanted to talk today about suppressed sexuality and emotional integration. So, sexuality in a holistic sense, first and foremost, is not just about sex. Sex is the part of it, but the sexuality and the energy, the sex energy, is the energy which gives us life. You know, when you think about where did we come from, and from the physical sense, it's because of the sexual instinct. You know, our parents did whatever they did, and here we are. So, when you have suppressed sexuality, there is a clear sign that there is some emotional aspects that are not integrated. And I think because sexuality is, or the sex instinct is something, is one of our instinctual things. So, for example, we need to eat, we need to drink, we need to sleep, and the sexual need is another one that is considered to be one of the basic needs. So, let's say if the person suddenly started not to want to eat, what does that mean? Something is not very good with them. Something is not very good with them emotionally. It's not just a symptom. Obviously, we stop wanting to have food, or sometimes we also stop wanting to have sex when we are ill because our body feels we need something else to recover. However, when we feel that we generally feel that we are ashamed about our sexuality or anything that is to do with sex, it means we are currently rejecting part of ourselves that is essential life force, really. So the sexual force is actually, you can say prana, chi, or whatever, but is, and if you would investigate tantra and kundalini yoga, you would see that there is lots of work on sexual energy or with that energy. So when you have suppressed sexuality, basically, what is going on? You suppressing your life force. So, and if you are suppressing your life force, that means you imagine this is whole you that could be experiencing life. So maybe you're suppressing, I don't know, let's say that part of yourself, and currently only this part of you is experiencing life. Okay, maybe some people have more of their self-expression coming through. And also, sexuality and sexual energy is so closely related with free self-expression. So even like, for example, ability to speak, even ability to create, even ability to kind of like feel what you need and share that. So suppressed sexuality is a symptom. And okay, how does it happen? Kind of like a short history or a short root cause analysis. So as children, the sexuality, people think, okay, because at the age when we are children, we're not being sexual because our hormones, the actual teenager or reproductive hormones, are not there. However, it's not true. As children, we are being sexual and we do lots of sexual exploration by understanding our bodies, which is autosexual phase, then understanding bodies of other people of the same gender, which is homosexual stage, and then understanding and exploring the bodies of the opposite gender, which is heterosexual stage. And if our development, if for example we are being shamed, punished or penalized, or like by our parents or other people who for example see us exploring our bodies, what happens then? One of those phases, it gets suppressed. Or overall, if the sexual behavior, for example, let's talk even about a religion, any type of religion, let's just talk about the religion that would see the sexual behavior as shameful, as sinful, as dirty, as unclean, you would get penalized, or you would be not a good, let's say, Christian, or you would be like not adhering to whatever rules, and there would be some penalties for that. So sometimes the environment that we are born in does not encourage the sexual behavior, and in immediately everything to do with the sexuality becomes shameful. So for example, let's take female periods. It's something like, I was born in Lithuania, and it was the time when I was born, it was still Soviet Union, and then post-Soviet Union, for example, when I was teenager, and I have my period starting. So what we and my friends would do, we would be so embarrassed when we would have a pad and we would have to go, for example, to the bathroom to change it. We would hide it to make sure nobody can see it. So there is big shame about even having your body, having processes that relate to that. So, okay, so basically, anyways, in my opinion, majority of people are sexually suppressed, myself included, but I think there is a degree of sexual suppression that differs. So the more sexually suppressed you are, the more emotional problems you have, or maybe you don't have many, maybe you have one, but it's pretty strongly suppressed emotional problem. So what to do about it? So there are things that you can do. You can do it either on your own, or you can actually see, you know, some therapist or go in some program or anything. But the first thing that you would need to do, you would need to actually acknowledge the fact that you are suppressing some of your sexuality, or you are ashamed about your sexuality in the first place, and then start reowning the aspects of your sexuality that you have rejected, disowned, hidden, and denied. So to do that, there are, like, I think one of the best things to do is a process called parts work. In the parts work, what you can do, you can actually literally imagine that you have that aspect in front of you, or if you not visual, you can take a piece of paper and start taking a note, and you can ask, okay, so who are you? So why are you suppressed, or why you have been denied? Why have you been disowned? And you basically start to kind of pulling those aspects back to yourself, and you start to own them that way. So is you don't have to kind of jump straight into being completely like liberated and open and good thing that you can do, but it could create crisis in your life. But there is a gradual process that you can take to do that. So reowning your suppressed aspects is probably the best way to go around it. Interesting tip, or the thing where you can see where you have it, is by looking where your attractions are. If you attracted to certain person, certain quality or certain thing, if you follow that attraction, you will be able to see that there is something about that thing that I'm so attracted, or that person, or that quality, that gives me something which I don't otherwise feel that I have in yourself. Like that, you can see in the best way where you have suppressed your sexuality. So if you follow that, it's kind of like a crumble path. I don't know what it's called, bread crumb trail. you can actually find it quite accurately. Hold on, just checking the time. Okay. Yeah. So it's very good if you have, let's say, some person, or if you may have some person that you admire, for example, some celebrity, and you find, oh my God, that celebrity is so fascinating. I wish I would be like her, or I wish I would be like him. So good way of seeing where you're suppressing yourself is you look at the qualities of that celebrity, for example, and okay, I'll use she, because for me it's like, for example, I like Beyonce. Beyonce is a celebrity that I really admire. And what do I really like about her? She is self-expressive. She is not, from what we see, it feels like, okay, she wanted to create her image in that way. She created her image in that way. She wanted to change it completely. She changed it completely. She wanted to adapt one musical style. She adapted one musical style. She wanted to experiment with something else. She is experimenting with something else. Meanwhile, she has a family. She has a husband and children. So she also has this container and the structure where she can do that. So to me, for example, in my case, that means I'm suppressing my free self-expression. I'm suppressing my freedom to chop and change. And how is that related to sexuality? Because all creativity and all self-expression in a huge way is actually representative of your sexuality. So that was just a quick kind of life on sexual suppression and emotional integration. I will be doing these lives regularly every morning on Monday, and I will be choosing a topic that I feel inspired or is interesting for me in that week. Feel free to send me questions. I can answer them if you know if there is something that is particularly interesting which I think can help many other people. And also, please share how do you feel your emotional integration is related to your sexuality. Do you feel as when you do emotional work you become more sexually liberated or in tune, in alignment, or you feel that spiritual work and, for example, emotional or psychological work disconnects you from that? Because that can happen too. So thank you for watching. This sign, hold on, you can't see it, says stay present. So stay present. I think staying present with yourself and your feelings is one of the best way to integrate anything in your life. And thank you for watching, and I will be seeing you next week with a new topic. And also, if you want, on Fridays I do Q&A, so you can join me then, or you can send me your questions. So have a nice day, have a nice week, and happy Monday. Bye.